Okay, thank you very much. I'd like to thank the organizer of the conference, the distinguished chairs, and the respected audience. I'm Bigdeli from Iran, and as you see, my topic is services of two handicapped students in the Iranian academic libraries. The contents, okay, next one, include introduction, research questions, methodology, findings, discussion, and conclusion. Next one, please. Human beings have always been facing with expected and unexpected incidents that may change his or her life. Even before the invention of motor cars, many people were killed in the streets by horses and cars. And now, due to the information development of technologies and industrialization of the societies, many incidents impose numerous loss of lives, and many job processes in industrial organizations have potential catastrophic outcomes for workers. Researchers are of two different opinions about the relationship between people and the incidents that happen. Some believe that job roots mainly have their roots in the organizations, but the other group, including Isaac, the psychologist, believe that this is the personality characteristic of people which is responsible for the incidents. Due to the importance of this phenomenon in the human life, in 1919, the concept of accident proneness was coined by Greenwood and Wood to focus on the causes of the industrial unsafety. So, after that, so next month, yeah, Sherry in 1992 reported five factors as the potential cause of incidents: psychological factors, environmental factors, ergonomic factors, mean the relationship between human being and the machine, and physical or body factors and stressors. Okay, next one, please. In 2006, International Library Organization, Labor Organization reported that each year approximately 317 million job incidents happen that caused 2.2 million deaths, and 116 million people are affected by diseases resulted from jobs, for example, chemicals or accident and so on, and 7 million people become unserviceable or disabled. This is the part of people that this study focused on. Okay, next one, please. In addition to incidents, we are always in danger of being affected by diseases even before the birth, when, for example, the embryo is just being formed, and by travel accidents. For example, in Iran, each year we have 40,000 people killed on roads, and I'm sure that 3, 4, 5 times more are injured, wounded. Some of them become well after a while, but a part of them finally become disabled, maybe temporarily or maybe for the whole life of them. And then natural disasters such as earthquakes, fire, or floods. During these days, I have been in Delhi, you know about the tsunami and earthquake in Indonesia, flood in South India, the metro crane accident. Of course, some of them result in the handicap of people. And then wars, which is a very big factor. Next one, please. due to the war between Iran and Iraq, we have... Okay, sorry, you go back to this one. The number of handicapped people throughout the world is 500 million people. 80% of these people live in developing and underdeveloped countries, and it is estimated that something between 2,600,000 to 2,800,000 disabled people are living in Iran. Okay, next one, please. And no, the previous one. So we have 5,000 students now in libraries, in universities. These are the warriors who participated in the eight-year war between Iran and Iraq. 700 of them are completely blind and the rest are suffering from severe vision damages. Okay, next one, please. The disabled people in Iran, like many other places, are three types, blind or partially blind, deaf or partially deaf, and people with mobility difficulty. Research about disabled people in Iran goes back to 1970. Most of them, all of them focus on blind people only. My research considered the people with moving or mobility difficulty, with hearing problems and so on. And most of these studies were undertaken only by one person, one female librarian. It seems that librarians are not, or many people are not interested in just considering or studying about them. Yeah. How many? Two, three? Yeah. So the research was going to answer these questions, to know the overall status of the students and to know the services and facilities available to them. I used the survey method, 120 universities, and under two different universities where the population, I sent the checklist with 43 questions to library managers. 102 checklists were finally analyzed. So next one, please. Go to findings. Next one. So as you see, the figures are 1, 2, 3. These are the universities, the libraries who had some facilities or services. This is among 102 university libraries. It seems that they are forgotten. Next one, please. And no university reported any special equipment, any special material, any services. For example, no browsing machine, no braille typing machine, no braille copier. But some of them reported they have easy access to different areas of the library. So the result of this study, okay, next one, is this. We found that disabled students are deprived of their right to access information, deprived from freedom of movement in different buildings and different roofs, and suffer from lack of equipment and information materials. So in general, we can make it just they are suffering from educational discrimination. Okay, what can we do is, okay, next one, please. Next one. I think a national or even global intention and active measures are needed to seriously consider handicapped students and help them to enjoy their social rights as citizens, students, and humans. You know, the present situation is in conflict with all librarianship principles and is in conflict with, for example, 5 laws of library by Ranganathan. If we consider, we see that these are all neglected in the academic libraries of Iran. Thank you very much.